Some people say we're all connected, all part of some bigger picture, some harmonious flow, endless and meaningful. Maybe that's how it looks from a distance. But up close, with eyes open, I see no evidence of any spiritual choreographer at work. No, I see nothing but the random fractals of a selfish, queenless hive. Never looking, never stopping, never meeting. Don't get me wrong, yeah? I'm not judging anyone. I mean, I want to get home as fast as the next person. But is it my unwavering selflessness that allows others to go before me? Or the selfish knowledge that the last one will be the first off? I mean, someone is always going to end up standing right by the door. To making sure it's me. Like it or not, life's a sinister competition, an endless series of choices, large or small, each with its own set of probabilities. All wind. Now that's an 80% chance. This is my train. It's worth a dash.
Excuse me, this train...
Random variables. Never underestimate the human factor.
Bond Street?
It's on the other platform.
Thank you.
There's two cars out, the rest are logged. Should be a nice, quiet night. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do.
And here they are. The most meaningful relationship I've ever had in my life, with a bunch of metal bimbos. Look at you, my beauty. You could keep me in college for over a decade.
Careful the way he saturates it with his ego. Ah, here he is. Did you put all wrongdoers to flight?
You can leave the keys to me, sir. I'll park the car for you.
I'm not the driver, son.
I do beg your pardon, madam.
No problem.
No tip.
Him or her, fuck.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes choices are so small you don't even see them. You are your decisions, that's what shapes you. And that last one shaped me into a little bit of a chauvinist, just like that pig in a suit.
Thank you.
forget something?
Not exactly.
I'm sorry about before. You know, just assuming like that.
Oh, ignore him. He was being an arsehole.
I think your boyfriend's an arsehole.
Don't you? But, does have a nice car. What are you reading?
Just a little bit of light study.
Looks pretty heavy to me.
Can I help you with something?
I need a favor. I need the keys to the Maserati.
Does Dr. Brent know?
Of course he does.
Okay. Okay, then you want my signing for it then?
Okay. He doesn't know. It's a secret, but I really need those keys. It's just for tonight. I'll be back before 2. Before 1?
Okay.
Good boy.
What's in it for me?
I'll owe you one.
One what?
One favor.
How do I know you're good for your favors?
You can bank my favors.
Fuck.
What?
Look, no more fast cars tonight, all right?
Turn around. Slowly. Now get over it. Drop it. Smart. Now get in the car. Oi, dickhead. Does it look like I can drive? You get behind the wheel.
You want me to drive you out of here?
That's exactly what you're gonna do.
Student, okay, I've got no money. My family's got no money. I'm worth nothing to you.
You're done now. Get in the house.
I checked your gear.
Just want to make sure I look the part.
And I want to make sure we are the part. Check your gears. Who the fuck is that?
It's the night guard.
What happened to your arm?
He fell 15 feet onto a concrete floor.
This is your idea of a slick operation. Dripping DNA all over the place, kidnapping the first innocent bystander.
I got the card, didn't I? It's outside.
Jesus Christ!
And who the hell's gonna drive? Because you're clearly not.
I'll be all right.
Fucking idiot. It has to be four people. There is no way you can manage the auction assistant and everyone downstairs on your own.
I'm well aware of how many people it has to be.
I have to call it off.
Do you want to tell Mr. Wu that we missed the one chance to get our hands on his fucking rice bowl? Because I don't. We have one window of opportunity and we're going to use it.
Fine. How?
Leave him to bleed. Need to make some calls and try and find a replacement in the next... Shit, in the next 30 minutes. Call Danny if he doesn't pick up. Try and get hold of that, you know, Irish Pete.
What about him?
Let's put a bullet in him. I don't care.
I'm not a murderer, I don't intend to start now. Pass me diphenoxin and a couple of cable ties.
You stay where you are.
Look, you said you wouldn't hurt me.
No, I said I wouldn't kill you.
That still leaves lots of painful options.
Not good at maths, are you, mate?
It's not supposed to mean.
Minus one, plus one.
I make zero.
Yeah, zero problems. Look, you need someone to help you out. And I need someone not to stick a fucking syringe in me.
Why on earth would I trust you?
Because you don't have a choice. Just like I don't.
I see your point.
Are you serious?
Are you going to go to the basement?
We've got no idea who he is.
After tonight, I'm not going to see him again. What difference does it make?
The difference is this guy looks like trouble.
Well, Mr. Wu is trouble, and we've made a deal with him we can't go back on.
What do you say?
I don't care who does what, as long as I get my cut.
You better not fuck this up.
What about the money? Don't push your luck. This is what's gonna happen. I'll double up on Lee's position. And this guy, what's your name?
Matt.
Matt sticks with Mei Ling. You take up the slack.
Super.
Okay, we need to get moving. We need to be at the auction house before 9. This one.
You're joking.
We'll find you something.
I think you need to tell me what we're doing here.
Nerve going already?
I'd just like to be prepared, that's all.
A very powerful Chinese clan called the Choys are here tonight to reacquire a porcelain ball that has been in the possession of the family for over 1,000 years.
Reacquire? What went wrong?
A careless business transaction.
So we're here to help them get it back?
We're here to stop them getting it back.
I presume you're not buying it.
What do you think?
Great. You know, I gave up stealing a long time ago.
To do what?
To study.
Then tonight's your lucky night.
How do you work that out?
Because the only thing studying will get you is unemployment.
Failed education is still no excuse for stealing, you know.
We're stealing from people who are prepared to spend millions on a piece of pottery when there are far more worthy causes in the world.
What on your worthy cause are you?
Tonight I am.
Yeah, I guess you could see it that way. You know, maybe you got a point about relieving some of these people of a sliver of their money.
Welcome to Hainsworth's. The second part of the auction has just begun.
Thank you.
$9.10 to my left. Thank you, sir. $9.10. $9.20. $9.20. Thank you.
I see you.
$9.30. Again to my left.
Third row on the left.
$9.40. Do I hear $9.40? $9.40. Thank you, sir. Looking for $9.50. $9.50 to my left. Do I hear $9.60? Fair warning. I'm selling. $9.50 once. 950 twice. So, for £950,000, this marvellous 12th century cabinet with its hidden compartment, which is
150 grand for its
time. Just try to keep it powder dry.
I'm sorry. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't spend it on a fucking sideboard. Sorry.
Why don't you try not talking at all?
So we come to what I feel must be the highlight of our sale this evening, lot 247. And to introduce it, first I'd like to pass you over to our expert, Miss Katie Tran. Katie.
What we have here is an absolutely exquisite example of late Ming Dynasty porcelain.
Don't stand now, mate. Is the ball there?
One of only three
simply beautiful pieces
remaining examples
okay, great.
Of a red
now.
Phoenix pattern
Simon.
Known to be in existence. Sebastian, if you would please.
Thank you very much indeed, Katie. It is a truly exceptional piece, the sale of which cannot be passed without remarking that its owner, Mr. Samuel Parr, who is far too modest to mention it himself, has agreed to donate 50% of the sale proceeds to the Chinese Art Restoration Fund.
Yeah, he can't afford it.
What did we say about not talking?
And so, we shall begin the selling. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Sebastian. And I would like to start the bidding, please, at £2 million. £2 million. Thank you, madam. £2 million I have to my left. Three I'm looking for. Do I hear three? Three at the back. Thank you, sir. Do I hear four? Four. Four to the lady. Thank you, madam. Four I'm bidding.
What the fuck are you doing?
Do I hear five?
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing?
Five, I get 20% on the sale price, don't we?
On the phone. Five I have. Do I hear six? Six I'm looking for. Six to my right. Thank you, sir.
How powerful did you say these toys are?
Do I now hear seven? Seven I have to the lady. Thank
Mate,
you,
stop man. Bidding.
Seven. Do I hear eight? Eight I'm looking for. Eight with you, sir. It's your bid. Looking for nine.
Matt, stop her.
Do I hear nine? Nine in the room? Nine I'm looking for. Nine to the lady, thank you, madam.
Christ
I'm almighty. Looking for 9-5, ladies and gentlemen, 9-5. 9-5, 9-5 to my right. So do I hear 10?
Matt, stop this.
Don't talk to him, talk to me.
We're looking to break 10, thank you, madam.
Are you out of your
10 we have,
mind?
We are at 8 figures in the room, ladies and gentlemen. 10 is your bid, madam. It's against you now, sir, so do I hear 10-5?
You are so getting lumbered with this.
10-5. 10-5 I have. Thank you. Now do I hear 11? 11 I have with the lady.
I'm
going
to have a heart attack.
You, madam.
Do you have a
11, it's
this?
Your bid, madam.
Yeah, gut feeling.
11,
okay,
so...
because you know, price
we have
11-5. Logarithmic curve, derivative
11,
approaching 5. Zero, so the chances of getting away with another
your
bid
at
than...
11, madam.
What a
11.5%.
Trust me.
11-5. 11-5 I have. Thank you very much, sir. 11-5, it's your bid. It's against you now, mate. It's against you, sir. 11-5. 11-5 with you, sir. Fair warning. I'm selling. 11-5 once. 11-5 twice. 12 million I have. Thank you, madam. 12 it is. So do I hear 12-5? 12-5 I'm looking for. 12-5. It's your bid at 12, madam. Looking for 12-5. 12-5. 12-5 I have to my right. Thank you, sir. 12-5. So do I hear 13? It's against you now, madam. 12-5. Are we all out? At 12-5. Fair warning. I'm selling. 12-5 once. 12-5 twice. So, to the gentleman on my right for £12.5 million. Thank you very much.
Let's get the hell out of here. You see, the wall doesn't turn on mathematics, you know.
Yeah, well, mine does.
Well, maybe that's your problem.
Right now, you're my bloody problem.
A problem that just increased your cut by about 25%? Now that's mathematics.
Where to?
The basement. Jeffrey's going to call the lift from downstairs.
Okay, and then?
Then you're going to take out the security guard.
I'm sorry, I'm going to do what?
Just follow Jeffrey's instructions, darling. We're a couple, remember?
So what do I do? Do I play along and try and get out of this later? Or do I try and stop this little crime wave dead in its tracks? Out of all of the probabilities, how did I end up here?
Follow me.
Wait here. When Simon gives the word, move out to the middle of the corridor and wait for the guard to come to you. Just say you got lost looking for the box. Simon, freeze the guard's image.
He's not gonna believe that.
I'll handle that.
Alert
the guard or let this play out. I might not get another chance.
Okay, Matt, go.
Stop right there, sir. This is a restricted area. What do you think you're doing down here?
I got lost coming out of the lift.
No, this floor's staff only.
Oh, I was looking for the toilet.
No, you wouldn't have come down here unless you meant to.
Simon, we're at the door.
Okay, you have to enter both codes simultaneously.
Got it?
Okay, timing is key here. The left keypad is 309220.
Okay, punch in the right code and I'm good.
On the right keypad, enter this. 085209, okay?
Simon, it's fucked. Get in the lift and I'll call it down. Hey, Ling, we need to come out the front. Bring the car to the front of the building.
I'm in the lift.
Let's go.
I could trust you. What the hell went wrong?
others? And Jeff, where are the others?
Ask him.
Let's get out of here.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back in society.
Let me see it. I want to see the bolt.
Just wait. This thing stays in the bag until we get to Wu's place and he turns it into money.
Too fucking right.
You want to take a left? Some Shoreditch High Street. Hong Kong City restaurant.
Sounds classy.
What are we going to do about this comedian?
Give him to me. I'll pop him.
Hey, that's not what we agreed. Not here, just keep him quiet until we get rid of this ball.
There should be some gaffer tape in the back somewhere.
Look out! Mei-Ling. Mei-Ling, can you hear me? Open your eyes. Okay, there's petrol, look, we've got to get out. Right? Fuck! Dead, come on. We need to get away from here. We're going to take this bolt to Wu's to finish what you started.
To Mr. Wu's?
Yeah, well, that was the plan, wasn't it? What do you want to do, Mei-Ling? Do you want to stay here? Mei-Ling! Okay, you have to do something. But look, come the fuck on, okay? We've got to go.
Welcome to Hong Kong City. Table for two.
We're here to see someone.
Table for four. Four on me, please.
It's going well.
Excuse me. We don't want to eat.
No problem. Bar this way. Four on me, please.
No. Mate. We want to see the manager.
You want to see the manager?
I want to see the manager.
You're not even eating?
No.
Your health inspector?
No.
Look,
Is Mr. Wu here?
Mr. Wu?
Mr. Wu, yeah.
Never heard of Mr. Wu.
Well, how about the Queen, mate? You heard of her?
Memory clearing.
You listen to me. Tell Mr. Wu that Mei Ling and Jeffrey are here to see him. You tell him right now, or you can pay the consequences.
Okay. You, wait here. Have fortune cookie.
Fortune does not come twice. Misfortune does not come alone.
Didn't know any better, I'd say you picked that one on purpose.
What does yours say?
Not telling.
Follow me, please.
Tell me.
No.
What's your business?
Why have you brought this here?
Because we had a deal.
I made no such deal. I have never seen you before.
Look, the man who made the deal is dead, okay? That's why we brought you your bow.
My bow? Atam, turn beige over here. Managing to steal that bow. It's quite impressive. But choosing to steal it in the first place is nothing short of insanity.
We stole this for you.
I gave no such order. Not to you or anyone else.
What?
To steal that bow is not only madness. It is also suicide. To the Choi family, possession of that bowl is a question of honor. They have fought wars for it. Its price is beyond measure. And I know how much they paid for it tonight. And I do not intend to add my life to the bill. Now get out!
What should we do with her?
If the choice catch you with it, you are dead. If you destroy it, you are dead. If you bring it back here, you are dead.
Doesn't really answer my question now, does it?
Not my problem. Atam! Go on, Corday Tofoy! Goodbye. We will not meet again.
Fucking great. I still want to know what my fortune cookie said.
Sure. A young man may trust his ears, but a wise man trusts his heart.
Did you know about the choice? How dangerous they are? You fucking did, didn't you? You knew everything Wu just told us, and yet you still bid against them and stole their damn bowl.
This doesn't really help us, does it?
It was the choice that ran us off the road.
We need a plan.
What do you suggest?
Hiding until we come up with one. I know a place.
No, we go to the police, Mei Ling. Like we should have done in the first place.
That's a terrible plan.
Well, it's better than hiding away from the inevitable. Look, we need to get rid of this bowl before the choice get rid of us.
If we take it to the police, they will arrest us.
Not for definite, no. I'll make it an even 50%.
You do realize your calculations and my gut are doing exactly the same thing? You just need the numbers to make you feel better.
My numbers are based on the information that we have, yeah? And rational mathematical algorithms.
Well, my gut feelings are based on experience and my entire subconscious. Do you know how many percent of your brain's activity are conscious? Probably less than one. Now that's a percentage. So trust me when I tell you that going to the police is a bad idea.
All right, let's go.
Did you believe Wu? They knew nothing about the job.
You look convincing, didn't you?
Yeah, that's not what I asked you.
John, thank you. And good evening from M Channel News. I'm on the
side. Not adding much to this conversation, mate.
I don't know. I thought we were delivering the ball for 20% job done. I should be back at home by now, soaking in the bath. Shit.
What?
There's no bath.
Somebody must want this thing. Why has no one tried to contact us? Is there any way we can get to just phone messages? Or what about that place in Chelsea? Maybe they've tried to contact us there.
Just shut up, could you?
Why'd you do that?
Because I felt like it. No time for love, Dr. Jones.
It's believed despite the extent of the robbery which resulted in the hospitalization of three employees, only one item was stolen from the auction house. A Chinese porcelain bowl, which had just been auctioned for the reported value of £10 million. The criminals left the location in two high-performance sports cars and subsequently disappeared. Though an explosion involving a third vehicle, which occurred 20 minutes later, beneath this flyover near Shepherd's Bush, is also thought to be linked to the robbery.
How the hell do they know that?
An explosion which completely destroyed the vehicle, its
car. Do you think the Choice will believe the bowl's history?
Your choice are worse.
I am deeply, deeply devastated by this event. If the bowl was indeed destroyed, then it is a loss to mankind which transcends value.
Oh, yeah. How very compassionate of him.
This robbery may also be linked to the murder of Anthony Wu, a a Chinese restaurant owner with known connections to the criminal underworld, whose body was found at...
Fucking hell. We was right about the choice. That's for fucking sure.
This doesn't make any sense.
May, we got him killed by taking it there.
And where next? We need to get out of the city.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree 100%.
Are you crazy? Having that is going to get us killed.
Well, not having it is what got Wu killed. Hello?
Mr. Smith?
Yeah?
I have some people in the reception. Shall I send them up?
Someone downstairs.
Matt, slow down.
I cannot believe you just did that. After everything we've been through tonight, you destroy the bowl just like that.
Just stop, will you?
When they find us, they're gonna fucking kill us.
It's not that simple.
Yeah, with you it never is.
Just stop. I can explain.
Inside. You destroyed the one thing that was keeping us alive. The one thing! Why would you do that? It's total madness, tell me why!
Because it was a fake.
I'm sorry, what?
The ball was fake.
Then where's the real one?
I don't know.
Then how did you know it was a fake?
Because I'm the one who forged it.
Fuck.
I'm sorry, Matt. I didn't know the implications. I was lied to just like you.
Fuck me.
We can still get the real one back and trade it for our lives. But I need your help to get it. Please. You have to trust me.
Trust you? Oh, I'm sorry. Am I hearing you right now? Okay. Okay, but these are my conditions. Firstly, you tell me everything you know. The whole story. And if I find out you've left out even the slightest detail, I am fucking gone. Secondly, from now on, we do things my way. Okay? I make the decisions and you agree with them.
Agreed.
Correct answer. Let's start talking.
I needed the money.
Yeah, don't we all? Who paid you?
Samuel Parr.
Wait, the guy was selling the bowl?
He couldn't part with it, but he knew the choice would never let him keep it.
So he had you forge a copy to sell to the choice?
To keep for himself.
You didn't believe that now, did you?
I believe in the good in people.
Oh, don't give me this bullshit! Where's the original now?
I don't know.
See, Parr must somehow be involved. But why the theft if you could just sell the copy?
He couldn't just sell it. At Haynesworth, they would have found out. Look, you can paint it perfect all you like, but you just can't fake the age of porcelain. Dating is based on an effect called thermoluminescence.
Thermoluminescence?
Yeah, it is a process to determine when the porcelain is fired.
Like
spark in a burning vehicle, you mean?
Oh, fuck me. You mean...
I don't know. You tell me.
Oh my god. If the forgery was retrieved from the van after the accident, it would have been indescendable from the original.
After the accident?
It was no accident, was it? That must have been part of Pa's plan.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Where are we going?
To Pa's. He's gonna regret this. I won't let him get away with it.
Beating him up won't solve our problem.
Well, it's a start.
Matt, you're not serious.
I'm so sorry to call so late, but I'm trying to get hold of Sebastian. Is he home? It's Jane? No, from work. Oh my goodness. Oh, that's terrible. Yes, of course. I'll visit him first thing. I'm so sorry.
What the fuck?
He's in St. Thomas's Hospital.
How is he?
He got beaten up, remember?
Is he okay?
Pretty serious concussion. Did you do that?
No, I didn't do that. It was Jeff getting his kicks. You work here?
As you can see.
Weren't you supposed to be going out?
The night somehow started badly.
Yeah, well, things would have gotten way worse for you.
Oh, don't start.
I'm sorry, but we are in a bit of a hurry, darling. Could you tell us which room Sebastian Leclerc is in, please?
Is he here?
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Oh, come on. It's just a room number.
Look, I know you wanted to help me out tonight, but I can't give you any information about that patient.
So he's here.
Oh, fuck, I shouldn't have even told you that.
Come on, Matt. Let's try the other.
Wait. Shit. She can't tell you anything because he was brought in by the police. She won't be able to tell you he's on the 7th floor, and she certainly won't be able to tell you he's in room 703. What? I didn't tell you anything. So, here's the girl.
Oh, I know her from work.
She works here?
No, my work. Her boyfriend parks his car there.
I see.
Is that jealousy I'm detecting?
Oh,
you wish.
They wanted me to use the internet.
Oh my God.
I know. You must be like 80, right?
No, no, no. I think I just worked out how Paul got the bowl out of the auction house.
What?
Come on. You remember me, right?
You shouldn't be here. Nurse!
Listen to me. I'm a peaceful woman. I don't want to hurt you. But if you try that again, believe me, the bits of you that hurt already are going to get much worse. Do you understand me? Do we have an agreement?
Yes.
Good. Now tell us about your deal with Samuel Paul.
You know you replaced the force in Rice Bowl with a forgery.
That's a lie.
Do you want to discuss that with the police, mate? Perhaps have a little gander at the surveillance footage with them?
They've already seen the footage.
Of the robbery, maybe. But what about the footage of you after you left the main auction room?
Of where?
The elevator.
There is no footage from there.
Ah, but that's where you switched it though, isn't it? And a camera must have seen you, even if you had your back to it. And if people know the truth, be clear to see what you were doing, mate.
Peter, what do you want? What do you want from me?
Where is the original? Does Paul have it?
If I tell you, you have to promise me not to tell anyone about me.
You're kidding.
You're in this as deep as we are, mate.
If you don't promise, I will tell you nothing.
We'll see.
Well, boy.
Okay. It's just you and me now, mate. Now, where is the fucking rice bowl? It's the last time I'm going to ask you nicely.
Okay. Okay. I swapped it. I swapped the original with the forgery, and I hid it.
Hid it where?
The cabinet. Pa's cabinet he bought in auction. There was a hidden compartment in it. There was a hidden compartment, right?
Yes.
Is that where it is? Is the bowl still inside?
I don't know when this is the truth. The security took everything after the robbery and put it in the safe storage.
Safe storage? So it's still inside Hainsworth's?
Yes.
Okay, you can take that off now.
We have to go back to Hainsworth.
How the hell do we get inside?
I don't know. But he does. Will this get us into the vault?
If you get to it, we... Yeah. You never heard about the hidden compartment.
Get well soon.
Yeah. Good night.
Wait here.
What did you say?
Oh, it's just noisy.
Look out!
What the fuck happened?
We have her. You find a ball. Bring it to us.
Who the fuck is this?
Bring it to the lobby of our hotel by 9 tomorrow morning. Or the girl dies.
Hello? Oh, shit.
No, I'm fine. I'm just killing time to my next appointment in 5 minutes.
With whom?
Mr. Quinn.
Okay, elevators are just there. It's on the second floor.
Great, thanks.
What do you think you're doing?
Your colleague let me in.
Who?
Mr. Quinn.
Mr. Quinn?
Mr. Quinn, yeah.
Wait here.
Going down?
Yeah, thank you.
Ground floor?
Car park.
You don't work here?
Picking up. Mr. Quinn sent me down. Oh shit, do I look shifty?
The car park's just through those rooms.
Thank you.
Wait.
I don't have much time. Have you got the ball?
Yeah. I'm in the back of Ainsworth and I've got it in my hand.
Don't bring it here.
What are you talking about? They're gonna fucking kill you.
Why can't you do that anyway? We need to prove to them that this was Pa's plan right from the start.
Any suggestions?
We need to get Pa to admit.
Salty. Salty now.
Please don't go wrong.
Mei Ling. Fuck. What do I do? Do I risk going to Pa's house to get us both out of this? Or do I take it to the choice? Now's my chance. No, I can't leave her to die. How could I live with that? I just need some kind of plan. Speak to the chief psycho.
Good morning.
I have an appointment with Samuel Parr.
Oh, Mr. Parr does not receive guests before 10 o'clock.
Oh, he'll want to see me. And he'll want to see me right now.
Wait here. Wait, you can't? Mr. Parr?
Thank you, Willa. I'll deal with this.
Who are you?
I'm here to tell you that unfortunately Mr. Leclerc failed to carry out his task.
What the hell are you talking about?
The bottle that was taken from Hainsworth tonight was a real one. Forgery never left that compartment.
Where is it? Where is it?
Catch. Don't worry. Just a copy. You don't think it'd be so stupid to come in here with a real one, do you?
Where's the original?
Mei Ling has it.
What does she want?
I don't know. Ask her.
Mr. Pa?
Clever little girl, aren't you? Not just a pretty face. How much?
Half the selling price.
6.25 million? I'd consider keeping the copy for that.
Then I might consider telling the choice.
You fucking little bitch!
Don't get on your high horse, Samuel. You tried to kill us all in that car crash.
And what about your bimbo?
Bimbo?
He's going to watch you transfer the money into my bank account. Then he's going to walk out of there and bring you the original.
Done. Now get me my original.
Okay. My friend is going to fetch it for you right now.
What the hell?
Mate, he knows.
Are you outside the house?
Mate, get out of there now. This is the bowl that Paul tried to steal from you. This is yours. Nothing more to do with this, all right?
Just wait! Baby! Help me! Please!
What are you going to do with it?
Discuss the nature of Chinese heritage.
Chances.